Hello dear friends, today we will learn another important topic, that is the conservation of mechanical energy. To understand this topic, first of all what we need to understand and what we have studied already, that we must know. We have already studied in the previous section that delta V, that is the change in potential energy, is equals to minus f of x into delta x, and on the basis of that we have proved the work energy theorem. If I consider that negative sign should be kept on left hand side, then this equation can be written as, this is minus delta v is equals to f x into delta x. So here I consider this form that we have derived yesterday as equation 1. This question and this equation, that is the formation from that equation number 2, I give it name as 1a. This is the same equation, but the negative sign is kept in a left hand direction. Now what? Now for simplicity, we demonstrate that the principle of one dimensional motion is how apply and we can understand that conservation of mechanical energy. Suppose we consider over here that one body that we are given over here undergoes displacement of delta x. Let us consider that this person is moving over here to here and undergoes the displacement, that is from xi to xf, under the action of a conservative force F. Then from work energy theorem we have the equation that we can already apply for this motion, that is delta k is equals to force, that is conservative force on x-axis, into delta x. We can see this, that the body that we have shown undergoes this motion under the force of fx. Now we have considered that the force is conservative, and therefore for the conservative force we have the potential energy also, that is given by equation number 1a. So here the equation 1a is another form of conservative force and the potential energy. Now the right hand side of both equation, that is 1a and equation number 2, are the same. The right hand side are the same, and therefore it is easy that we can compare the left hand sides. So from this equation what we can say, we can simply apply, and what we can say here, we can say for the example, that is delta k is equals to minus delta v. See, here delta v is a change in potential energy, and therefore if we combine these two equations we can get delta k plus delta v is equals to 0. But what is the equation meaning? Here they both are having the change in their kinetic energy as well as changing in their potential energy. So in general, if we want to write, we can say that delta of both k plus v is 0, and this is very most IMP equation for the consideration as example over here. So here this equation I can give it a number 3. Now on the basis of this equation number 3, we can say that the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy of the body is a constant. It can be written as, because delta K plus V is 0, means the sum, that K plus V is always constant. So we can say that therefore K plus V is always constant, and therefore their change is always 0. Because suppose I have one value, that K1 plus V1 is equals to 5 and K2 plus V2 is also equals to 5, then the difference between this K2 minus K1 and V2 minus V1, that will be 0. So here the same thing, that the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy of the body is constant for the given path. Now suppose we are moving from xi to xf, as I have shown here, that object, this object has started its motion from, suppose, again I am repeating, that suppose it was over here and it had started its motion from xi to xf. So if it started its motion from xi to xf, that means that at the initial stage it has the kinetic energy, suppose ki, and potential energy vi, and at final stage when it reaches the f, it will have kinetic energy kf and potential energy as a vf. So now if we consider that kinetic energy and potential energy as given in the question, then we can say, as per as the equation above 3, that ki plus fi is equals to vi. So ki plus vi is equals to k final plus v final, and this final and initial value belongs to on the x-axis. Now the quantity, that k plus v, is called total mechanical energy of the system. So from this equation that we have obtained over here, this is the extension of that equation number 3. I can say that this is equation number 4, and ultimately we can say that this k plus v, or ki plus vi, or kf plus vf, as ultimately this equation for us, that is kv is constant, is called our new, that is total mechanical energy. I give it name as equation A, and k plus v is called the total mechanical energy of the system. Now individually the kinetic energy k and potential energy v may vary from point to point. So it is also important that suppose you are at this point, suppose here another point is there, say x dash, here suppose any another point is, suppose x double dash, here suppose there is x triple dash, and so on. So here we say that at point to point, that is at point x dash, x double dash, x triple dash, at each point they may have different kinetic energy and different potential energy, but the sum of the kinetic energy and potential energy is always constant throughout the path. So the sum is constant, and therefore the aptness of the term, that is conservative force, is clear, that because it does not change. V means I, that is ki plus vi, suppose at x dash it is kx dash vx dash, suppose at x double dash it is kx double dash vx double dash, and at suppose at f it is kf and vf. वी से के आई, के एक्स डैश, के एक्स डबल डैश, के एक्स ट्रिपल डैश, के एफ, ऑल आर डिफरेंट. वी कैन से दैट वी आई, वी एक्स डैश, वी एक्स डबल डैश, वी एक्स ट्रिपल डैश एंड वी एफ ऑल आर डिफरेंट. बट एट ए पॉइंट द समेशन ऑफ के एंड वी फॉर द गिवन पॉइंट इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट इज द क्लियर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द कंजर्वेटिव फोर्स. नाउ let us consider some of the definition of the conservative force as given in the textbook. For the given term in the textbook, we can say that a force is conservative if it can be derived from a scalar quantity V by the relation given in the equation number 1a. So here our equation number 1 and 1a, if we derive force from this equation, then it is considered as a conservative force. The three-dimensional generalization requires the use of vector derivative, which is outside the scope of this book. This is written in textbook. That means for three dimension, we do not have to worry about this topic. Now, second definition, that is the work done by the conservative force depends only on the end points. This can be seen from the relation that we have derived over here, and that is that ki vi plus kf vf, that is equation number 4. So if we take the differences over here, what we will have, that we can say that if we take differences, then what we will have, I can say that is kf minus ki is equals to vi minus vf. So this is the information that the work done by the conservative force depends only on the end points, and it is proved over here. So this is exactly it equals to work done or work energy theorem. Third thing that we can derive from the equation above also, that is third definition, that states that the work done by this force in a closed path is zero, and this is once again apparent from equation number 4, equation number A, equation number 3. That is all, if consider xi is equals to xf, then ki is equals to kf and vi is equals to vf, and therefore if we take differences, that will be zero. So in short, we can say that the total mechanical energy of a system is conserved if the force doing work on it are conservative. So if forces are conservative, the total mechanical energy of the system is also conserved. So this is called the concept behind the conservation of mechanical energy. Now we can understand this topic in another way also. Let us consider one more example, that is also the part of the chapter number 3, that is that basic gravitational acceleration and its motion. We consider, suppose, a body that is moving on a certain axis. If we consider three different stages for that, that is ground. Here I say this is zero or ground. It is ground. Then suppose this is another height, say a small h height, and this is total h height. So this is total h height. I have point 0, I have here point 1, and I have here point 2. Suppose one ball is held at this point. Suppose I have one ball that is held at this point, and then I release it under the gravitational force. Then what are the different conditions that we have already? That at this point we say Vi is zero. Then suppose when it reaches over here, this is suppose V dash is equals to, we say it is Vh. And suppose when it reaches over here, we say that this is V final. So here V initial is zero. Suppose V dash is some value with Vh, and at finally on the ground its velocity is suppose Vf. Now what we can say, that a ball of mass small m being dropped from a cliff of a height h, what we can assume over here, that the total mechanical energies, say E0 belongs to point ground, EH belongs to point h height, and E of h belongs to capital H point, that is h height capital H. Now what we indicate with respect to that, here it is very clear that at height capital H the object is stationary, ball is stationary. So whatever the energy, that is only potential energy at height, and that at height kinetic energy is suppose zero, and therefore at height we can say that all the energy is has, that is mg into h. If the mass is small m for the ball, so that mg is the force acting in the downward direction. So all these things, that mg is the force acting in downward direction, mass m is considered, and h height is given. So if initially it is stationary, and therefore the kinetic energy is zero, and we can say that the whatever total energy is its potential energy. I say it equation, another equation, that I can say it as a one equation. Then suppose at height h, I want to write at height h, I can say that it is Vh plus kh. Now at Vh I can say this is potential energy is equals to mgh, and kinetic energy is equals to 1/2 m Vh square. So this is our equation number 2 that we can over here. And again at ground, that is at E0, if we say that V0 plus K0, here clear again, in this case at this point here we can consider this potential energy on the ground, that will be zero. So whatever energy, all the energy will be with kinetic energy, and that is equals to 1/2 m v f square. So this is the total three different energies we have. Now as the law that we have stated here, that the conservation law, we have to compare and conserve condition, and we can find out different velocities at different height. So suppose I want to find out the final velocity, what I need to do, I compare equation 1 and equation 3. So from equation 1 and from equation 3, what I can have, what the terms I can have, that is E0 is equals to EH. Now we apply it for the term. So what is E0 and what is EH? We can say that E0 is 1/2 m Vf square, and EH is nothing but m gh. So if we compare them, we can have that m term will cancel out over here, and therefore if we take vf as a subject, so vf square is equals to 2gh, and therefore here vf is equals to under root 2gh. So this is exactly a familiar equation that we have already derived in chapter number 3. Here this is our equation number 4. So this is the same equation that we have derived earlier in chapter number 3. Now suppose I want the velocity at height h. So for that I can say that from equation 1 and equation 2. We can compare now equation 1 and equation 2. Here for equation 1 again I can say that E h is equals to E small h. Now I put all the terms, that E h is equals to nothing but m g h, and at E h height it is m g small h plus 1/2 m v h square. Now we have to compare this term also. So here first of all the term of m that will cancel from each statement, each equation, and therefore now from each term we have removed m. Suppose we want to make v h square as a subject, so this is equals to 2 times, and this g h will goes to the left hand side, so it will be g h minus small g h. So if we say as a simplification, we can again get 2 times g capital H minus H over here, and if we again get V H as a equation, we will have that is 2g and H minus H. So this is our another equation. I say that equation number 5 for my derivation. So this will be the equation number 5 over here. So ultimately all these are our known equation. As equation number 4 is derived in a similar manner, we have derived equation number 5, and from this we can say that at height capital H the energy is purely potential. Now it is partially converted to kinetic energy at height small h, and it is fully kinetic at ground level. So we can simply illustrate all these things, and we can say that this is called that conservation of mechanical energy. So this is called conservation of mechanical